Parvati, who is the most powerful god's wife, and they call it as Shiva, the most powerful god's wife, does she need a security? Okay, that's again a question mark. Then he is created, and Ishvara is, her husband is out. As per Hindu belief, he is the, the superpower god. He comes back home and he asks, who are you? I am surprised again that how can the creator of this entire world ask, who are you? In his own home, what is happening, he does not even know. So what will he know my problems? His wife has created a person as a security and he himself does not know. And he comes to his home and to surprise, he'll ask, who are you? So I was again shocked and said, okay. And still he wants to go inside. And the Ganesha resists that my mother is taking bath, I cannot let you, this is my duty. And the Shiva chops off his head with the Trishul. I was like, how can be so, merciless and ruthless that he chops off the head just because he did not allow, him to get in while wife is taking baths. He can meet, he does not even have patience. And she comes back from the bath and she sees that the entire scene is changed and she gets angry. She asks, I need my son back. You have done such a this thing. And Shiva says, no, I cannot undo what I have done. This is again a surprise to me. The most powerful God, the creator, in Hindus that if he opens his third eyes, the world will be flat. With that kind of belief, he cannot just put a head back and he says, I cannot undo. And he orders his people that go get an elephant's head which is sleeping in this particular direction. What justice is this, cutting elephant's head and putting it to him and giving a life while he has a limitation to join the same head back? And to my surprise, why should I worship Ganesha? Because he was not even able to save his own head. So what will he do for me? How can I worship him? How can I have a belief that he is God? So again I was shocked. But I was reading Quran in parallel. And I started questioning my parents also, who has seen God? My parents used to reply, nobody has seen, but we are doing it just because our forefathers are doing. Well, I mean Surah Baqarah, Surah Baqarah says, while the truth has reached, will you still remain in ignorance like your forefathers? So it's true, many times I used to confront my mother and my father when a cat goes in front of us, they used to say, don't go. Or, in the morning when the crow, when it shouts, it said, don't go. So I used to say, these are all blind beliefs, you don't have knowledge, so I have knowledge. This is all modern times, so I don't agree with you. And, similarly, Quran is saying that they were ignorant of something, while you have a knowledge, will you still remain ignorant? But still I had my doubts on Islam. I said, okay, history can support me. I thought, I am from Mysore, right? So born and brought up in Mysore till my 10th standard. Where Chamundi Hills is there, Chamundeshwar. I thought, okay, there is a history, there is a place. So this God, for sure, she will save me now. Because who else can deny that there is no Chamundeshwar? Because her temple is there, her hill is there. So there is something. So I went, I checked, okay, her history. Now the name, as per Hindus, Mysore came because of Mahishasura, that demon, evil, actually. Now he is in meditation for long, long years, Mahishasura. And Brahma, who is one of the powerful god again, he is pleased with his meditation. And he comes and says, I am pleased with you. Whatever you want, you can ask now. Now, this Mahishasura, he says, I want to be the most powerful person in this world than anybody else who is present today. And I should be eternal. The death should not approach to me. And, Brahma says, okay, granted. And he goes back. Now, this Mahishasura, there is a place for these gods to stay actually. Their place is known as Devaloka in Hinduism. And the normal human being, they are staying in this world, which is known as Earth. So this Mahishasura, after getting this power, he starts waging a war against all these gods, going to Devaloka, where the gods are staying. And all of a sudden, all these gods are scared and they run away to Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, and they go and ask, what have you done? This guy is coming and he is killing us. What has happened? We have to prevent him. And this Brahma says, okay, I granted him a boon. That's why he is doing this. So they request him, can you undo it? Brahma says, no, I can't undo it because I have given him a boon. So I can't take it back now. And can you stop him at least from this harm? He said, no, I can't stop because my boon is activated now. So how illogical that he is, you know, I can fool God, sit for 10 years, get a boon, then kill the God. How illogical is this? And still, okay, fine, what do they do to kill him? Brahma says, I have a solution. What I have given him is, you will be the most powerful person in this world than anybody who is present. Which means any newcomer can be most powerful than you. Okay, then, so how do we get this newcomer? So, the Shiva and Vishnu plans. Vishnu says, I will become girl. Something, it should be unnatural, otherwise we can't kill him. So Vishnu says, I will become a woman. Shiva and me, we will have a, you know, get together. And the baby will be born, which is a newcomer, and he or she will kill. And the baby which is born is known as Chamundeshwari, which goes and kills him. I said, it's so illogical. Why so much of complexity is required? You know, like, if they have to become unnatural and a man becoming a woman, women becoming a man, and then having a, you know, get together, and then having the baby, then killing, why don't you do it? It's much easier task. So this is, I felt, okay, this is a nice story to be told to the kids, but something which I cannot believe. And I was by-handed all these ritual mantras which I used to pronounce, this, you know, Gayatri mantram, all this. And in any of these mantram, most of the times we never used to take the name of these gods. When I checked this literal translation of this, actually, it was just like, you know, guide us to the light, you know, come, you know, guide us to the light, remove us from the darkness. When I've read Surah Fatiha, it's the same, which is Ihdinas Siratal Mustaqim, it's more or less the same. So, and I started again investigating and talking to my parents. All the priests, all my relatives, they had to give only one answer, that, you know, we are just doing because our forefathers are doing it, so you don't need to question it. So, well, now I was sure enough that Hinduism is all about mythology. And I asked some question to my grandmother, that, you know, I am reading Quran these days, and I am, you know, what is, do you know anything about this book? She said, yeah, Quran is from the God, so it's a noble book, you know. She was very excited, and she said, it's a very divine book. And then I asked, what about Ramayana and Mahabharata, what are these? She said, this is written by somebody, Valmiki. She said, this is written books. So I was like, you know, why should I believe in somebody else's written books when I have a book which is from the God? But still my faith is not strong to believe that this book is from the God. But my nani is saying that this book is from the God. So I was like, is it really true? And I started reading Quran. I thought, okay, why should I, you know, bend myself to him saying that Hinduism is wrong? Let me also verify what Christianity is all about. And I did not take much time to analyze Christianity as I did Hinduism. Because what I heard from, you know, my friends and some of the known people was, Christianity is, Jesus, we have one God, okay, and Jesus is the Son of God. And he is the only begotten Son. I was not, you know, this analysis I was doing at the age of 17, I really did not know the meaning so well, that what is begotten, what is not begotten at all. So it did not make sense for me. Jesus is Son of God. Why does God need a son? You know, why does God require a daughter or a son? The more or less Christianity concept is closer to Hinduism. Even in Hinduism, Ishvara has God, Ganesha has God, Hanuma, you know, everybody has sons, you know, children. So, you know, we require our kids because, you know, if I want to identify myself later, my death, you know, in our religion they used to say we need boys more than girls because, you know, our khandan should grow. So that is why we need kids, at least the boy. Why should God require? And I always used to verify, and they say, Ganesha, who is Ganesha's father? Ishvara, who is Vishwara's father? They never used to have answer. The chain used to break somewhere. So the Christianity really did not make sense to me, that it's more or less very close to Hinduism, that they have a Son of God, and they have a God separately, they have a Holy Spirit separately. And, you know, during my period of Mysore, I was staying in a place where there was a Christian missionary who used to stay. That's a place called as Pushpashram in near Rajendra Nagar in Mysore. So I used to see them, what they used to do. So I had that knowledge, okay, they used to worship Jesus. And even in their prayers, they used to call Amin, Amin, Amin. So, and when I, you know, heard this person reciting surahs and all, I also heard he says Amin, Amin and all. Or whenever we used to go to his shop and he used to say some nice things to us or nice things to his brothers, fellow Muslim. And when they made dua, he used to say Amin. It's like, oh, okay, you know, Christians also used to do the same thing. So then I thought, okay, Christianity did not make sense to me. I thought, okay, let me read Quran further. And in Surah Bakara, Allah says, I will not forgive the shirk. You know, shirk is something.